Good afternoon, Coyotes. On today's show, we'll check in with some of you and see how you are surviving middle school.
See what your plans are for the end of the year and look in on Mr. Purser's highly acclaimed jazz band.
We're your guest anchors, Lily Wright
and Brittany Shalkevich,
and CMS TV starts now.
Why'd you turn away? Here's what I have to say. I was left to cry.
The book fair is almost here. Please stop by May 28th through May 31st and find a summer treasure. The end of the school year is approaching fast. All library books are due May 30th. Be prepared to bring a book from home if you need a reading book for class. Textbooks will be returned June 4th through the 6th. There are so many amazing and talented musicians here at Calavera. From orchestra to band, everyone seems to be in tune. But did you know we have our very own jazz band? Here is Nina.
So my brother was playing jazz band in middle school, and then it kind of disbanded when no one wanted to play it in the between years between we were in middle school. And so then I thought to myself, maybe we could start it up again. So a group of five of us asked Mr. Purser, and he said yes, and then we recruited more. Now it's a full-scale jazz band.
I joined because I like to play the trumpet, and jazz is cool.
Well, I joined jazz band because only cool cats are in jazz band, and I'm a cool cat.
Okay, so you can join jazz band by either getting an invite from Mr. Purser, or you can ask him. Don't worry, he may be sarcastic, but he doesn't bite. And you should at least know how to music apparently. But you should have a little experience with how to play some instrument, and pretty much any instrument can play, so.
If you are interested in having an amazing 2013 through 2014 year at CHMS, then ASB wants you. ASB's job is to build a strong and caring community at our school by leading great activities, exciting tidy communities, and involving every student here on campus. You may pick up an application from outside Ms. Williams' class, room 104. Applications are due on Friday, May 24th. We're looking forward to a fantastic year here, and we are counting on you to be a part of it. Do you ever feel like you can't go on anymore? Do you feel like middle school is more about surviving than it is about hanging out with your friends? Well, if you do, you're not alone. Here's Casey with some of your stories.
Hello, mate. Casey Robb here, and I'm going to teach you how to survive middle school. Let's go. One way to help you survive middle school is always be on time. One minute till the bell rings. Yes! Another way to help you survive middle school, always make sure you're kind to your teachers.
Hello, Mr. Sotillo. You look very nice today.
Thank you. What a nice young man.
Another way to help you survive middle school, always make sure you're kind to other students.
Why do we have to do that?
Another way to help you survive middle school, always make sure you follow the rules. Otherwise, this will happen.
Hey, Sammy, here to see me? in here.
This is Casey Rob reporting for CMS TV. Now back to the anchors.
Eighth graders, please return your promotion photos and payment, if you're purchasing any photos from the package, to Mrs. Soper. All photos not purchased must be returned to the office. If you were absent when photos were delivered to your PE class, please stop by the office to pick them up. As Teacher Appreciation Week comes to a close, make sure and thank a teacher today for all their hard work and dedication this year. Got plans for the end of the year? Let's take a look to see what some of you have in store for yourselves as the end of the near the end of the year draws near.
Now that we're in May, some people are thinking about what they're going to do at the end of the year. That's why we went out to see what some of you guys are looking forward to do during the summer.
Shred the gnar with Ard, Sam, and Luke. Hang out with friends, skate, go to the beach, and relax.
Go to Mexico.
I'm going to Lake Tahoe. And I might go to a One Direction concert.
I'm gonna shred the Narna and skate with Ard Demito.
Next, we ask the same students if they're excited to be in the grade they're gonna be in next year.
No, because I'll be too busy shredding the Narna with Ard Sam and Luke.
No, because once summer begins, I'm not really gonna wanna go back to school.
I'm excited to be in eighth grade next year.
No.
Definitely not.
With you cavities are ready to start next year, I'm personally excited to start 8th grade. Reporting for CMSTV, I'm Dominic Galata. Now back to the anchors.
8th graders, don't forget to turn in your baby pictures to your advisory teacher ASAP. The extended deadline is May 31st. Yearbooks can still be purchased. See Mr. Lyon for order forms if you are interested in owning an amazing piece of middle school history. At the Music in the Parks Festival last Saturday, the CHMS Instrumental Music Department represented our school in a fine fashion. The beginning band, the string orchestra, and jazz ensemble all received excellent ratings. The advanced band also received a good rating. The beginning band received the best overall award for middle school bands. On Doe was selected as the outstanding jazz soloist. Congratulations to all of these special student musicians. After the performances, the students spent the day at Disneyland. Most of you have seen the show Dual Survival, right? Well, here's Calavera's interpretation as they brave the unknown.
The wilderness of Calavera Mountain, a popular tourist spot for many people. Hundreds of hikers come here every year. Many become lost. Some are never found. On this episode of Dual Survival, Sam and David will be taking on the roles of two lost hikers who must find their way out. Cooperation is paramount in a survival situation like this. We need to work together to get out of here.
If you don't know what you're doing and when you're gonna do it, we're gonna die.
Hey, look at this. Backpack.
Humans leave trash everywhere, so it's almost certain that you're gonna find something that you can use if you know how to use it.
Let's see what we have in here. An empty water bottle.
Could be used for storing water if we find some.
ESP?
There'll be no fooling around in a survival situation.
Look at this, a switchblade.
Hey man, that might not be school appropriate.
Just a comb.
Stupid sensors.
Some deodorant? I don't know what we'd use this for.
He needs it.
Another comb? I guess they wanted our hair to look good. And a unicorn hunting license. This might come in handy later. Alright, let's load this all back in here. By the way, where are your shoes?
I always forget something.
Whatever, let's just get out of here. My training with the Boy Scouts is extensive. Oh, with over 3 years with them, I know that you need to get your essentials and get out of here fast, or you're gonna die within days or weeks.
In my decades of teaching my students the arts of survival, I've learned that you need to take advantage of your surroundings and use your natural resources. Like this berry. It's been used for generations by the indigenous people as a nutritional supplement. Delicious.
David has gone out to scout ahead in case there's a water source nearby.
This river that you can hear,
it obviously has to connect somewhere We gotta be able to bottle this water. Let's hope we found some.
Man, there's some water over here!
There's water?
Hey, yeah, get that water bottle out!
Let's go!
This could mean we survive instead of dying.
Always use a moving water source, because if it's standing still, it could build up bacteria and disease.
And that would kill you faster than anything else out here. You get water, you survive.
That's good, dude. Take a swig of that.
If we want to get out of here, we're going to need a signaling device. So he's going to go get the food, and I'm going to save our butts.
A perfect example right here. Under the rock, smarties work. Look at this cave. Looks like there's a guy in it.
Before we go, here are a few important dates to remember. May 27th, Memorial Day, no school.
May 29th, open house. The jazz ensemble will be performing at open house on May 29th, and all of the instrumental groups, along with choir, will present their final concert of the year on June 5th.
May 31st, talent show. June 5th, orchestra, band, and choir concert.
June 6th, drama cabaret. June 7th, 8th grade awards. June 12th, Drake Benner's birthday.
And 8th grade dodgeball game, along with the cookout.
And June 13th is promotion.
Well, Coyotes, that's all we have time for today.
Remember, only 3 weeks to go. So what does this mean? Don't start celebrating until June 14th.
You have come too far to fall apart now. Keep up the good work, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.
Wait a second, what about my package? Freestyle football. My package is about freestyle football, not soccer, and they do really cool stuff with the football.
Okay,
the real football, not the football that they throw the ball on. I don't know why. So enjoy.
Okay, let's roll it.
Hey. I wanted to tell you something about freestyle football. In freestyle football, the pros juggle footballs and they do really cool tricks. So enjoy. This is the Red Bull Professional Freestyle Competition.
He also likes to taunt the other guys. Even in the training yard, he was taunting every other baller out there. He was particularly giving Avalos a hard time back there. It was funny to watch.
Yeah, he is very Italian.
Yeah, at one point Avalos just turned it to begin.
That's it. Very nice around the world, yes.
That's almost like double leg.
Oh, this is amazing.
And the audience is
he is the only one to know. He feels confident. Some ground moves.
Oh, the taunting just continues between these two superstars of freestyle soccer.
This trick is a tribute to Mr. Wu, who created this trick.
Shows a lot of all-around skill by Sian.
Like you see, Gunther is showing the judges that Sayan is touching it with his hands, something that's not allowed in Rebel Street Style.
The place feels good. No time to call you today. I'm crossed till 11. Chinese food. Back to the hotel again.